I'm going to take this opportunity to talk to you about a general overview of research we are doing at IIIT Delhi. So, I just want to let you know, this is nowhere an exhaustive list of everything which has been going on at IIIT Delhi. This is just a couple of things which was on top of my head while compiling, and some of the things I feel are really cool. And more details you can always find on the websites. So, just because we are from academics, we like to give some stats, because IIIT Delhi that way outside CS community is not that known of what it does. So we have 6 centers of research. We have an incredible force of PhDs and professors and students who publish almost on every, we publish at a very highest. So if you pull out number of A-star papers published in last 10 years, we almost rank equivalent to places like IIT Delhi and IIT Bombay, whereas we are just 10 years old. We started doing it 10 years ago, and our CS departments are comparatively really strong. That shows like how, what's the pace at the research goes on here, and it's still good quality research because it's all A-star and A papers. We have alums everywhere around the world. I can't think of any college or big place where people are not working. Like this year we have like 7 students going to CMU only. And then there are Harvard, Georgia Tech, Stanford, and these are just stats for this year, and we have old students everywhere. And we have collaborations around the globe with companies and research institute. But apart from these academic stats, there's some cool stuff. So there's a professor called Professor Saket Anand, and he's probably one of the only big names in India who is trying to do things like self-driving cars. And one general thing about research at IIIT Delhi, we don't like to get confined only to papers. We do publish papers, but the aim is always, can we take that technology and deploy it in real life? I know very less PhD scholars from IIIT Delhi who has not built their research into a product and deployed and tested it before they defended it for their PhD. So for this project, we have an e-rickshaw, and the aim for this project is like terminal connectivity from metro stations to nearby areas. So these are meant to do that. These are not meant to do like any general purpose traveling. So from a metro to nearest bigger stations. And we have this e-rickshaw, we have a Mahindra does this self-driving competition. We have a Mahindra car given to us, and we try to put our sensors on it, build system and test it. Right now it's being tested to drive around IIIT Delhi campus and from IIIT Delhi to Govindpuri metro station fully autonomously. UAV, so we also do a lot of autonomous drones tests. So recently there is an annual competition which is done in by US Navy for these unmanned aerial systems, and IIIT team recently got 6th there. These are a team of, I think, 1 PhD and a couple of undergrad and RA students. And we have been competing here for the last 3 years and been getting in like top 10 teams from last 2 years regularly. Something which is very different from AI or these kind of things, this is Gehna from our design lab. So this paper was published in CHI 2019. It's the biggest HCI conference in the world. And they talk about how jewelry can be used for input modality to, let's say, your phone and appliances around the house. So how jewelry can be converted to wearable inputs. And something called virtual bricks. So VR is all the hype, but the problem with VR, it's really expensive. HTC Vive in itself is multiple grands, and then you have to buy other accessories around it. So the idea of this project is, can we take Lego blocks, insert a sensor in a Lego block, and build props with these Lego blocks and use that with something like HTC Vive? And again, it's a working model, it's been published, and now they're trying to get it more fine-tuned for something like productions. And then because I work in MIDAS and PCOG, I am more aware about what is happening there, so I'm going to talk a lot more detail about that stuff. So MIDAS is a multimodal digital lab. It's headed by Dr. Rajiv Ratan Shah. He's a PhD from NUS. and postdoc from SMU. We majorly work on multimodal research of social media data and other stuff. So one of the problems which I am personally working on is detecting trolling on social media. So how we can, let's say you can go to a Twitter user, or you can just open up your Twitter feed and see, okay, which one of these is potentially hate speech or trolling. So can it be detected automatically, and how can probably be wrapped into a mobile app or an extension where it can be deployed to end user, so they can be warned about something. Because currently Twitter and Facebook relies heavily on the reporting system, but the big problem there is people don't report stuff very often. So fake news is another big problem one of the PhD students is dedicatedly working on. These are some of the examples of when 2000 note came in, there was all the hype around it. There was a news which said Sylvester Stallone passed away. And US presidential election 2016 was a big hub of fake news. So how these can be detected in conventional articles, because there are now fake websites which just publish fake news. And in social media posts also, which is a bit harder because of the shorter context and the content. Then we have Lipper and speech reconstruction, which I wanted to show a demo of it, but internet is not working. But the idea is we have these systems which can, if I'm speaking right now and there is no audio, it can read my lips. That system can look at my lips and reconstruct what I'm speaking. And applications can be, there are some diseases where it can be helpful, or a simpler application can be just, it can be a part of a video calling app. So to get a more smoother experience. So it can just look at the lips and generate the audio itself. So if you go to our YouTube channel, we have demos of how it works. I don't have internet here, otherwise I would have showed it. But if you just type MIDAS at the IIIT Delhi on YouTube, you'll see the videos. And again, it's not on idealistic data sets. We train on idealistic data sets, of course, but you would see in our demo that there are people like us from our lab are speaking and it's being reconstructed. One of the projects we did with Arcana Labs USA was kidney diseases. So you have kidney biopsies, and a lot of early detection of these diseases can be done by looking at these biopsies. But problem with countries like India is number of people who are qualified to read these kidney biopsies are very less compared to number of people who need the who get affected with these kind of diseases. So we were getting labeled kidney biopsies from Arcana Labs USA, and we ended up building a system which can look at it and can potentially warn that maybe this biopsy can lead has some disease cells, and then a professional can look at them. And then Precog is the second lab I work with. Precog is very similar to MIDAS. We are primarily social media lab. We also do some security stuff. It's founded by Dr. Ponurangam Kumaraguru, more famously known as Dr. PK. He is a PhD scholar from Carnegie Mellon University. His research during her PhD was something called Fish Guru, which is one of the biggest contributors of like stopping phishing attacks around the world till today, which got later converted into other very famous company called Wombat Securities. But we also do a lot of social media stuff here. So some of the projects I'm going to discuss is Skillfy. So how many of you take selfies? And how many know people die taking selfies?
They are not here.
Yeah. And this happens for the good or the bad, like in India a lot. And India is also famous for when we are doing research in a special kind of selfie deaths, which is called group selfies. Like five people are trying to take a selfie together and none of them noticed and like got into a hazardous situation. So this project started as we looking at a Washington Post article, and then the news kept on coming and coming. So we kept collecting some data. Later on, we built a model which is now deployed as an Android app and soon in an iOS app. This is just a selfie camera, but every time you try to take a selfie, it analyzes the surrounding and says, maybe it's not a safe place to take a selfie. Like it got covered in Patriotic Act by Hasan Minhaj, so yeah. It's got a lot of attraction there. Then we have a lot of other projects which I would like to talk about, but one project which we are working a lot is general election 2019. So for the last 6 months, since more than 6 months, since October last year, we started collecting data related to Indian election, and we ended up collecting a lot of data. I'm talking in millions and millions of tweets, profiles of close to 60 million people. And we collected all this data, and while we were collecting, we were looking it for anomalies and posting live about it face to face. So some basic analysis of this data you can find on our blog. Again, I can't talk to you, but we have data for each phase, and we have a lab page where there is a detailed analysis of this data. So things we observed, like one thing is people from Congress follow a lot of people from BJP, but no one from BJP follows anyone outside BJP. That's just one pattern we saw, and we saw hundreds of patterns like this, and we are extensively doing research on bigger anomalies which are harder to detect real time now. So things like looking at suspected users, because there was a lot of news around how political parties are using IT cells to create rumors. Can we detect those? Can we detect how hashtags was used? So there was this thing that 2019 election was fought on social media. Is it even true? So we have 2014 data and 2019 data. So all that research is going to come out really soon, and we are going to open source this data very soon once we get a understanding of what all it's in the form, and then we're going to open source this entire data. You can look at a lot about these projects on the blog. All the blogs are live and a lab page. And a big part of this data is already live, along with the cell kill fee data with other projects. So we have Facebook Inspector done in the past, which looks at how credible a Facebook post is or how credible a Twitter profile is. All those data sets are available on our resources page. You should look at them. Please check out the website. There is a lot of stuff I wanted to talk about on the website, which is not here. But yeah, and then talk to us, because we are almost always looking for people. If you are you have already graduated, you can apply for a research assistant position, a PhD position. If you are still an undergrad, you can always apply for intern. We are almost year around looking for smart people, cool people. If you have done something cool, just push an email to us and we would be happy to interview you. Almost daily updates of what is happening in the lab goes on for both the labs on the Twitter pages. Follow the professors, follow the profiles, talk to us. Feel free to give us an email about if you have any question regarding research, and we would be happy to help. And I'm going to hang around if you want to know more.